John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Philippians 4:13. I can do all this through him who gives me strength. Romans 8:28. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and the future. Psalm 23:2-1. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Matthew 6:33. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Romans 12:2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing and perfect will. Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Isaiah 40:31. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. Ephesians 2:8-9. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. 1 Corinthians 13:13. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Matthew 28:19-20. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. James 1:22-24. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. Romans 8:38-39. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation, will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Psalm 46:10, he says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. John 14:26. Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, the new is here. Matthew 5:14-16. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Proverbs 4:23. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Matthew 20:37-39. Jesus replied, love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment, and the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. Psalm 27:1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? Romans 10:9. If you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. John 14:27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. 1 Peter 5:27. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Psalm 119:105. Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. John 8:12. When Jesus spoke again to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Galatians 6:9. Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Psalm 46:1. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Romans 5:8. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Proverbs 16:3. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. John 15:13. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. Isaiah 41:10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Philippians 4:6-7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Colossians 3:23-24. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is the Lord Christ you are serving. Psalm 139:14. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. Romans 8:1. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Proverbs 19:21. Many are the plans in a person's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails. John 3:17. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. 1 John 4:18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. James 4:8. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Psalm 34:8. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Ephesians 4:32. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. Matthew 5:44. But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Isaiah 42:8. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God endures forever. Romans 12:12. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Matthew 6:19-21. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. 1 Corinthians 10:13. No temptation has overtaken you, except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful, He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. Psalm 46:2. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea. John 14:1. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. Romans 8:18. I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us. Proverbs 16:9. In their hearts humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps. Hebrews 13:5. Keep your lives free from the love of money, and be content with what you have, because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. Isaiah 43:2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. Psalm 19:14. May these words of my mouth and this meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Romans 8:26. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. Matthew 6:24. No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. To Timothy 1:27. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love and self-discipline. Psalm 119:11. I have hidden your word in my heart, that I might not sin against you. Romans 15:13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Proverbs 22:6. Start children off on the way they should go, and even when they are old, they will not turn from it. 1 Corinthians 15:58. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Psalm 37:4. Take delight in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Romans 8:38. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation, will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. John 3:30. He must become greater, I must become less. Philippians 1:26. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Psalm 56:3-4. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I praise. In God I trust and I am not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? Romans 14:11. It is written, as surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow before me, every tongue will acknowledge God. John 16:33. I have told you these things, so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Psalm 37:7. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret when people succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Romans 1:16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes, first to the Jew, then to the Gentile. Hebrews 4:16. Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Philippians 2:3. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, In humility value others above yourselves. Isaiah 53, 2-4-5. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. Romans 10:17. Consequently, faith comes from hearing the message, and the message is heard through the word about Christ. Psalm 37:23-24. The Lord makes firm the steps of the one who delights in him. Though he may stumble, he will not fall, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. Hebrews 12:1-2. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Psalm 91:1-2. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. 1 Peter 2:9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Matthew 11:29. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Romans 6:4. We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. Psalm 103:2-8. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in love. Romans 8:24-25. For in this hope we were saved. But hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what they already have? But if we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. 1 Peter 3:15. But in your hearts revere Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect. Matthew 5:16. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Philippians 3:13-14. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Hebrews 10:25. Not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Psalm 100:5. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. John 14:2-3. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Romans 12:9. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Psalm 139:23-24. Search me, God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. James 1:5. If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. Romans 3:23-24. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and all are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. John 1:14, the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.